veteran journalist, senior advisor, Minister of Information Broadcasting, and was my colleague during my political innings at the 11 Ashoka Road. Sri Gautam Chintamani, author, historian. Srimati Prerna Bohra, editor, Bloomsbury, India. Distinguished dignitaries, brothers and sisters, who are all watching this program online. I am really happy and delighted to launch The Midway Battle, a timely book by Sri Gautam Chintamani that offers insight into India's eventful journey during recent years. The Midway Battle, it was aptly, wisely titled. And I have gone through the book. The issues has to be analyzed critically, objectively, with an open mind, and then provide an opportunity to the people to make their judgment. But information, inside, analytical, has to be given to the people. I always say, information with confirmation is more than an emanation. People want information with confirmation. You know what is happening in the information sector in the recent years and over the years. Sensationalism is occupying center stage. Sensationalism means encouraging senselessness. And that is a trend. And the people are carried by headlines. And some of the journalists or the editors who put these headlines, they think it's a deadline. This kind of books, which are very informative, analytical, are the need of the hour. It's an eventful journey. As Kanchan has said, it's a battle. India is a huge country, 130 crore population, with great civilization, past history, and still battling with many of the issues, even basic issues. We are the largest democracy in the world. Started our journey 7.5 decades ago. Where are we moving forward? Where do we stand? With a strong faith, of course, that we can emerge as global leader once again. Leader is to guide, not to lead and occupy. Because we, Indians, Bharatiyas, we are against colonialism. As India enters the 75th year of independence, we should look at our journey and ask ourselves many questions. Have we lived our destiny, the country? Have we progressed enough as per our expectations? These questions are never simple. The test of our actual progress is not how much we have added to our abundance. It is whether we have provided enough to those who had little, too little. India has always been a place that has inspired the world. Writing contemporary history is never an easy task. Being witness to something as transformational as the change in the lives of 1.3 billion people or 1/7 of the humanity can risk oversight. It's an all-important task as chroniclers of the present can better understand what is going on than future historians. Our nation has made great strides since the turn of this century. It had often been envisioned that 21st century could be India's century. The last few years have borne great witness to the transformation of the average lives of the people, average Indians. Both empowering them and enabling them to deliver their potential, be it life expectancy, financial inclusion, access to health care, employment, owning a house, or honoring entrepreneurial ability, access to drinking water, transport, education. Indian lives are getting better with each passing day. The Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Bhai Modi, has given a three-word mantra: reform, perform, and transform. Transformation of the lives of the people. Transformation of the system. Transformation of the delivery mechanism. Transformation of the thinking of the people. In this spirit, every sector in this country today is witnessing an unprecedented change and reform. In the last 7 years, setting a world record in financial inclusion, world record, more than 430 million people have been connected to the banking system in India. Over the same period, more than 360 million, most of them from underprivileged backgrounds, have been provided insurance cover. 87 million women from below poverty line households have been given LPG connections. And 52 million households supplied with a tap water connection. Stating these statistics is one thing, but comprehending how these pro-poor and people-centric initiatives affect and change people's lives is entirely different. In the true spirit of minimum government and maximum governance, the government is leveraging technologies to bring transformation in every sector. Digitization of processes has not only plugged leakages in welfare schemes, but also made people's lives a lot easier and hassle-free. With concerted efforts like Startup India, Stand Up India, Mudra Loans, India has become the third largest startup ecosystem in the world. The pace of progress is such that over the last 1 year, India has added 3 unicorns every month. It is testimony to the government's resolute commitment to improve the business environment in the country that India rose from 142nd position in 2014 to 63rd position in the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business Index 2020. My dear friends, there are still many challenges in our path. But challenges are nothing new for us. Many challenges. Our freedom fighters toiled selflessly to break the chains that bound us to an imperial power, and our founding fathers laid the foundation on which we could rebuild our civilizational heritage. Since independence, every time we took a step forward, bigger obstacles were placed in our path. Yet nothing could deter us from path of progress and humanity. This is why India's success is the success of the world. We have always believed in philosophy of Vasudeva Kutumbakam. The whole world as one family. Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. Share and care has been the core of Indian philosophy. My dear sisters and brothers, many doubted our potential. Many still question our ability. But the world has time and again seen how India sets big goals and achieves them. The corona virus pandemic has come as a big challenge for the entire human race. And India's efforts during this pandemic have changed the way the world looks at us. The world's largest free COVID vaccination drive is currently underway in India. We have already crossed the 125th crore vaccination landmark milestone a few days ago, and this is an example of how nothing is impossible when India sets its mind. Dear friends, the emergence of a new coronavirus strain has created renewed fears in people's mind. I would advise people not to be panicked, but remain vigilant and keep following COVID appropriate behavior. I also urge everyone to shed hesitancy, if any, and get themselves vaccinated at the earliest. Because so far, according to the scientific study, that is the best way among the available things. Together, with everybody's cooperation, we will be able to defeat this pandemic. I am confident about it. The midway battle is a commendable effort by Sri Gautam Chintamani. I believe it will give all of us, especially my younger fellow Indians, an understanding of how this period is a great challenge for us. India stands at the point where it has left the doubts in the past behind and is looking as far ahead as possible. With the greater realization of its beliefs, the recent past has made all Indians believe that it is possible to reimagine and witness India emerge as a self-reliant world leader. At the same time, the geopolitical challenges in the aftermath of COVID-19 have made the world rethink our position. We are no longer an afterthought. Our commitment to upholding democratic values and respect for all lives continue to shine. India's strategic partnership, both new and old, are based on mutual respect and are a joint effort to safeguard each other from the race of expansion and inclusion. We are guided by our unwavering self-belief and our dedication to become Atmanirbhar in every possible way. Even in the shadow of a global pandemic, the kind of which is not seen in 100 years, India stood firm against enemies known and unseen. We have given a resolute response to inimical forces who dared to challenge our integrity and sovereignty. See, Gautam's book also puts into proper perspective that lies ahead of India's largest democracy. India's vision of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Prayas is looking at the world as a whole. We believe in taking the world together. Our challenges are not over. Our challenges are not over. We have many challenges. Illiteracy is a challenge. Poverty is a challenge. Even 22%, 20%, the estimates can vary. It's a challenge. Discrimination, gender discrimination is a challenge. Social discrimination in certain parts is a challenge. Urban-rural divide is a challenge. Delivery system, more efficient, effective delivery system is also a challenge. The DBT, direct benefit transfer is a revolutionary transformational idea. At the end of the day, the parliament may make policies, legislations, and governments of the day may have good intentions, good programs, but unless they are delivered to the people without dilution, without deviation, it has no meaning. So direct benefit transfer, I said in the morning, I repeat, I'm repeating everywhere, direct benefit, reaching the people, their entertainment, it is not a mercy of anybody. You are elected to deliver, pilferage should not be allowed. Some time back, our former Prime Minister said only 16 paise of rupee reaches people. So we have to see that there is no line, no waiting list, no shortage, no black market, no need to go and meet and greet, shake hands and do something in between hand. There should not be any necessity. It's a reality, you are all aware of it. I am not trying to make any political point. People should get their entertainment. And every rupee they pay as a tax, the resources we mobilize should go to the people, and that too, the marginalized sections, the weaker sections, antyodaya, reaching the poorest of the poor. That is our objective. And it's time for all of us, Indians, during this Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, to make introspection at various levels, from top to bottom. How far we have traveled? What are the challenges ahead? What is the road map? What is the responsibility of every Indian, every person? There is a discussion sometimes about nationalism, about patriotism, after this many years of independence, after colonial past, we are still discussing what is nationalism. Nationalism is in the nation's interest. What is nation? Nation is not only a geographical boundary, it's a people. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one. Unity and integrity of the nation, it's welfare of the people. That is nationalism. That is patriotism. How do you achieve this patriotism? Someone asked me, simple. If everybody does their responsibility, that is patriotism. If everybody, every person perform his responsibility, that is more than patriotism. Thinking in terms of welfare of the people, working for the larger interest of the people, safeguarding the security of the people, safeguarding the boundaries, and making people's life more happy. What is required is not only comfort, you need to provide people happiness. We must work on happiness index while taking care of these basic shortages. We must improve. Improve the functioning of delivery, improve the functioning of the parliament, improve the functioning of the legislature, improve the standards of our writings, improve the way we communicate with the rest of the world, because you are all aware there is a lot of negative propaganda against India. The other day I said some people, some nations, some are not able to digest India's emergence again. They are suffering with indigestion, I can at best say. But time has come, and I am sure, I am happy that India is being recognized. India is being respected everywhere. And Indian culture, Indian heritage, Indian value system, Indian ethics are being appreciated by one and all. But for that, all of us should follow ethics which our forefathers have given us through years of ages of their living and follow it in everybody's life by performing our responsibilities. I am sure if all of us make introspection and all of us dedicate ourselves to the cause of the nation, think in larger interest of the country, leave this negative mindset. What is required is a positive mindset, positive. Positive in the sense of not the pandemic. Positive is an unwanted word in the COVID. Positive mindset. Constructive mind, not obstructive, because obstructive means it will be destructive. One must have constructive mind. And we should all become partners in the developmental story. It is not the duty of the government alone. It is the duty of all political parties, all people who are in various layers of administration, even the bureaucracy, that we must always try to improve further and take care that the average standards of the living conditions of Indians are improved a lot. And India is able to shine once again. Once upon a time, we were known as Vishwaguru. Vishwaguru, as I told you, not to capture or not to lead or this thing, not to make anybody as colony, but to share our knowledge for the betterment of the lives of the people. This is a Mahayajna. This is a battle. Battle, it's really a battle. Fighting corruption is not an easy joke. We are all seeing. And taking care of these disparities is also a battle. Fighting the status quo is a battle. Bringing reforms is a battle. So we must all join this battle, Mahayajna. I call it as Yajna. Yajna for betterment of the lives of the people. Yajna for a self-reliant, prosperous, happy and strong India. Let us make our efforts sincerely. I am sure we will be able to succeed. I would like to compliment Sri Gautam Chintamani. Many such books should come from various sides and then allow the people to have their own analysis. Thank you very much for joining today at this simple but meaningful function. You are all aware because of the COVID. We are not allowing bigger functions because of the restrictions and also to maintain that needed Surakshita Duri. It is not social distance. Surakshit for our own raksha. We have to maintain that distance and also follow the COVID protocol recommended by scientists and then move on. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.